And now is a time that you'll be happy that it's not Smell-O-Vision, because we're going to talk about stink bugs. Now, they're really more than just a smelly nuisance. The invasive species is threatening crops, and that could potentially drive up food prices.
One more thing we don't need, right? That's coming at the worst of times, with prices at the pump rising and trying to recover from a recession. 11 News I-Team reporter Lisa Robinson has more now on what's become a multimillion-dollar agricultural problem.
12, 13.
Doug Inkley is counting the brown marmorated stink bugs in his home as he vacuums them up.
Here's another one. It's disgusting.
I vacuum when I get up in the morning. I vacuum several times a day when I'm home, and I vacuum before I go to bed.
Eight right there. That's a small number.
The National Wildlife Federation scientist has the bugs coming out of the walls on every floor in his Knoxville home in Western Maryland. Since January, he's found and documented more than 19,000 of them in his house.
They get in my kitchen sink. They get on my toothbrush. When you're sleeping at night, the only warm thing in the bedroom is your body, and they seek out warmth. So they land on you in the middle of the night, and they're just a terrible nuisance.
This stink bug is an invasive species from Asia. It's believed the bug stowed away in freight containers that ended up in Allentown, Pennsylvania. The first infestation of stink bugs was confirmed in 1996 when homeowners there started seeing them.
They're not going to bite you. They're not going to bite your pests. They might have a little taste of a houseplant. Okay, that could happen. But they're also not going to breed in your house. They don't reproduce indoors. All they do is chill out there for the winter.
University of Maryland entomologist Mike Raup says as the weather warms up, the bugs will head outside to feast on fruit, trees, and favorite summertime crops.
It's like a mad scientist bug. It is the perfect thing to threaten our food supply.
And threaten Carroll County farmer Dwight Bogger's livelihood. Bogger says he's just now seeing how much damage the stink bug has done to the apple crop as he takes them out of storage to sell.
Them little dimples is stink bug. This is what it does below the surface. It means I'm losing money.
Bugger says with some varieties of his apples, he will see a 50 to 70% loss. Some apples will only be used for juice or jelly, not turning the same profit as an apple for eating. Bugger's even more concerned about what's to come.
Those sweet cherries, strawberries, peaches. We got a lot of time and sweat invested in a crop of peaches with hand labor, that if this thing comes in with a lot of numbers and stings it a few times, that peach is going to be thrown on the ground when we harvest. It will be junk.
They poke a hole in it, and they suck out the contents. But they don't suck out enough to shrivel the grape, but they poke a hole in it.
Eric Allen of Linganore Wine Cellars in Mount Airy is worried about his grapes. He says once the bugs damage the skin of the grape, bacteria gets in and starts to ferment the bunch from the inside. Allen says he's had to use a broad-spectrum pesticide to kill the stink bug, which then kills all the other bugs, good and bad. And he says you actually have to spray the bug to kill it, not the plant.
You have to get them off of the plants before you harvest, because you don't want that stink bug in your wine, because they smell really bad.
The USDA is taking the brown marmorated stink bug very seriously. The bug has now been seen in 33 states, but the worst infestations are right here in the mid-Atlantic states: Maryland, Virginia, West Virginia, Pennsylvania, Delaware, and New Jersey.
In fact, Maryland has joined 9 other states in submitting a grant proposal for $22 million to the National Institute of Food and Agriculture, searching for solutions to the stink bug problem.
That means looking for insecticides that will kill the stink bugs and not kill those bugs that are beneficial to local crops. Raup says it's a slow process.
We had fruit growers this year put on more than 22 applications of pesticides and still not get good control.
A solution could come from behind these doors. Quarantine inside this USDA lab in Delaware are parasitic wasps. They're native to Asia and natural predators to the stink bug. Research entomologist Kim Homer traveled to Asia in 2005 and brought them back here.
These small parasitic wasps attack and develop inside the eggs of brown marmorated stink bugs. And each of these parasites is about a millimeter in length.
As the tiny wasps develop, they consume the eggs of the stink bug from the inside out, But it will take several years before scientists will be sure it's safe to release the exotic insect into our environment.
Learn its traits.
So growers like Dwight Bogger are doing everything they can to help find a solution. Dr. Tracy Leske, research entomologist with the USDA, put these traps up in his peach orchard.
These are visually stimulating pyramid traps that the bugs orient to. They're also baited with a known attractant for brown marmorated stink bugs, so we can monitor presence, abundance, and seasonal activity in commercial agriculture.
While Dr. Leske is monitoring and counting, Doug Inkley continues to count and vacuum.
18, 19,
and since
20.
No one knows when there will be a solution to this pesky problem, looks like we're just going to have to get used to the little stinkers. For the 11 News I-Team, I'm Lisa Robinson.
And if you're wondering why they're called stink bugs, well, of course, they're named for the foul odor that they emit when they're frightened, squashed, or disturbed.
To combat them, scientists are also planning to petition the Environmental Protection Agency. They want permission to use an insecticide currently used on other crops, but not permitted in apple and peach orchards.